Ms. Phillips a few months ago for this course. And I want to make this course more attainable. Does it sound,
I think we need to reset that a bit. Okay, hold on just a second. Got something there?
I'll give anything in.
Okay, hold on just a little. Do this good bit here.
Is everything wrong?
There it is. Okay, again, Ms. Phillips, before December, what, December 15th?
Yeah.
Hello, everyone. Today we're gonna learn about the past possibility. I've heard a few sentences on board.
It's okay, cause he's not going, I'm not gonna leave him up there long.
Is that a flip phone?
Yeah.
What can you do on a flip?
Have you ever done that though? I mean, I actually got to have written like that on the top. Was I back to the classroom? You don't do that in middle school, though.
No.
Or in high school.
Okay, can you please read number one?
Oh,
Jenny Paul could have misunderstood what he meant.
Misunderstood. You should say misunderstood.
Misunderstood.
Okay, number two.
Sue and Mary.
Sorry about that.
Would you, can you just close the tab? I can still hear something buzzing.
Yeah, go to the one to the left of that.
Right
there, yeah, that one.
Yes, close.
Hit your X there, yeah.
Okay. That's not me, though.
There we go, okay.
Okay, this in this particular slide, we had to move from an off-campus site back to campus. And I had 30 minutes time to get packed up before we had to leave one classroom and go to another one. So everything got packed into boxes, just thrown in there as fast as we could get it. We still don't have it out. We still don't have my stuff out. So my students, now this is after some of our manipulatives here. I had never seen the algebra tiles until Steve introduced them. One of my students brought this yardstick, and they did all this. They did the writing and everything on it. They did the negatives and the positives. They took this out on break. This was taken at Wilkes Community College out there on those stone walls that they sit on during break time. And they were working algebra problems.
That's great. That's great.
Using their own manipulatives. And that just tickled me to death. And a little girl, well, she's not a little girl, she's got four children. But she took that picture. She took that picture and emailed it to me. But that's Miss Phyllis getting out of the way and letting them. And they are, they're becoming teachers. They're actually doing it. But now this is not the Miss Phyllis that you saw on the other slide. Okay, this is our class. Like I said, our supplies, our materials, and things that we have created in the other building, we don't have those yet. And so we tore apart this probably candy wrapper. I'm not sure what this was. To work, I only had one student that was working in surface area. The rest of the students, they got involved in the measuring of each little section and all that, and took notes and all that. But they didn't exactly understand the concept surface area. They do understand volume. We talked about that just with their drinking cups and their bottles. And I'm talking about volume, but. This is all student student created, and even the flag there. This is, I think that's actually a student computer. And our portable hop and slide now. We had a hop and slide in the old classroom that we put tape on the floor and put numbers on. But we don't have that room anymore, so this is actually a student's idea. We found the colored paper in our new classroom. It wasn't ours, we actually stole it. And they did the zero, the white you see is the zero, I think, yes. And then we tried to find some red paper. We found a pink piece of paper to use on the negative side. And that was their idea. We're going to get red paper and create our portable hopping slide. And it's going to be all red on the left-hand side of zero. And so having that concrete, something they can touch thing, has helped illustrate the difference between negative and positive numbers. And they have fun with it down on the floor. They like moving around to the from the negative to the positive. And when they solve the problem physically that way, then they can sit down and write it out on a sheet of paper and visually see the why of the answer they got. So that, again here, that's Miss Phyllis getting out of the way. And that has been the best part of this for me. I'm a hoverer, I'm a nurturer, and I want to do everything. And the best way for me to do that now is to get out of the picture. And that's been the aha moment for me right there. Get out of the way and let these people do what you know they can do. And they make this hop and slide. And I actually like this one better than I did our tape on the floor. So we're going to work on this and have a humongous, it won't be very humongous. Our classroom is about a third the size of this room. So we won't be hopping and sliding very far. And then we have had a lot of fun with my function junction. They play with this. Right now it's kind of invisible because we really don't have anywhere to sit it. But my students love the function junction, and basically, though, right now they do the same function over and over and over. But it really gets used. There's lots of hands-on and lots of discussion, and I don't think there's anybody that has come in hasn't been introduced to function junction. These manipulatives have really changed Miss Phyllis as far as her teaching methods, and I have apologized big time to my students, former students. My favorite of all is the algebra tiles, and we have worn out paper using the algebra tiles. Now this is just an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, and we've got the problem worked up there with our algebra tiles on the sheet of the paper. And I tell them that the vertical line is the equal sign. And we try to keep all these lying out on the table somewhere too, and they come in and sit down, and I try to create a new problem, and we always use every side of the sheet of paper. So this is the naked side of a used piece of paper there, so we're not wasteful. But I put lots of these out with various different problems and try to put new ones out to some where they have to work different problems. But this is actually my favorite.
Did they draw on that one?
Did they draw on that?
That yellow one right there?
Oh, was yeah. We didn't have any red ones, so we made our negative ones, wrote the negative sign. Okay. So that's a negative one, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We had to do that. I don't know why we didn't have any red tiles. Maybe we ran out. I bought three packs of these, and they kind of disappeared. I think the students kind of take a liking to me. This is a video I want you guys to watch. I think you put that up here, didn't you? How do I get to it?
We got it.
I want you to meet Miss Phyllis of the future. This is what I want to be when I grow up.
Maybe we want to check this in here. Maybe you do that.
The volume's off on the computer.
Oh, yeah.
He was warranted.
Okay, let's try it now.
This is it.
For most of us, hearing about your birthday on the radio is a seldom occurrence. But for Brooklyn math teacher Madeline Scotto, it's pretty much warranted.
She's a teacher, and now she's a math bee coach.
You're famous. How do you feel?
Oh, this is exciting.
Mrs. Scotto is celebrating a milestone, turning 100 years old. What's even more incredible, she is still part of the workforce, working as a math instructor at St. Ephraim's Elementary School in Dyker Heights. 100 years. Is it surprising to you?
Even though I'm in the math, I sat down one day and actually did it with pencil and paper. I just couldn't believe it.
A lifelong resident of Brooklyn, Mrs. Scotto is a mother to 5, a grandmother to 9, and a great-grandmother to 16. She became a teacher when she was 40, returning to St. Ephraim's Elementary, the same school where she was part of the first graduating class. And she never looked back. Why did you ever want to retire?
Oh no, that's the bad word. Some people like what they're doing, but I have a passion for what I'm doing. And when you have a passion for something, you never give up. It's challenging, but that's what the world is about. I mean, you just can't sit back and do nothing.
I wanna have a job that I don't rush.
And sit back, she does not. Still very much in tune with current events, Mrs. Scotto has an opinion on almost everything.
I'm not deliriously happy with television lately. Too much advertising.
I agree with you.
Oh my goodness.
And her advice to the youngins, get off your phones.
When you get together in a social group, everybody's there with the head in their thing and there's no conversation going on.
I'm kind of guilty of it, Mrs. Scott.